Gospel according to St. John, the 17th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus prayed, I ask not only on behalf of these, but also on behalf of those who will believe in me through their word, that they may all be one. As you, Father, are in me, and I am in you, may they also be in us, so that the world may believe that you have sent me. The glory that you have given me, I have given them, so that they may be one, as we are one, I in them, and you in me, so that they may become completely one, so that the world may know that you have sent me, and have loved them, even as you have loved me. Father, I desire that these also, whom you have given me, may be with me where I am, to see my glory, which you have given me because you loved me before the foundation of the world. Righteous Father, the world does not know you, but I know you, and those know that you have sent me. I made your name known to them, and I will make it known, so that the love with which you have loved me may be in them, and I in them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. 13 years ago, film critics were raving about a movie called The Guardian. It was the story of a U.S. Coast Guard senior chief named Ben Randall, who, according to the story, was one of their most daring rescue swimmers. Now, Randall had the reputation of going places and taking the calls that nobody else would dare. Eventually, he retires from that job and becomes an instructor at the Coast Guard Academy. Until one night, many, many years later, when Jake, a young officer whom Randall has been mentoring, gets a call to rescue people on a sinking ship off the Aleutian Islands in the middle of a raging storm. Now, Jake, of course, takes the call and winds up in serious trouble. So Randall decides to go out with the backup crew, knowing that he's probably the only one who can get Jake to safety. And all goes well until they're being winched up out of the ocean into the chopper, and the cable lifting them, dangling them hundreds of feet in midair, begins to crack. Randall knows the cable can't hold two people, so he unstraps himself from the safety harness and plunges toward the ocean so that Jake will survive. But as he falls, Jake reaches out his hand and grabs hold, gripping him as tightly as he can, holding on for dear life, growling through gritted teeth, I won't let go. And Randall answers him, I know. And so he unstraps his glove that Jake is holding, frees his hand, and plunges into the sea. The narrator says that despite one of the most exhaustive searches in their history, Randall's body was never found. A few weeks later, at the end of the movie, Jake and his crew are rescuing a stranded fisherman in that same region. And as they pull him up into the chopper, this man starts asking about the other guy in the water. What other guy in the water? There's nobody down there. There was. This guy came up and grabbed me. He grabbed me and held me up out of the water. And he kept telling me he'd be there and stay with me till help arrived. He never let go. He never let go. That's not just the ravings of a freezing, starving man lost at sea. It's the cry of human nature. We all want something, somebody, that will never let go. Precisely because things in life do, sooner or later, let go. In Easter's final days, we're here to look for our risen Lord, only to find that he has ascended and returned to the Father. And so, with John's followers who are writing this gospel, we wait. By the time the Gospel of John is written, the apostles, including John himself, have all long since died. A second generation of Christians is writing this, a generation that's rising and spreading and dividing across the globe. Since each group has its own bishop, the question arises, who is right? Who are the real Christians? Who are the real, true descendants of the apostles? Whose church is the actual church? One of John's followers, who's contributing to this gospel, a guy by the name of Ignatius of Antioch, says that the way to determine where the real church is look for where the bishop is. Okay, but when you have hundreds of bishops, does that argument still hold water? Hence, rolling through Easter's last days, looking through this, looking through truth, we wind up going in different directions. And so, in these days, using the tool of excommunication, more and more Christians were letting go of each other. That's why Ignatius and the other authors of this gospel wanted to include Jesus' prayer, a prayer that no other gospel records, a prayer not only for those sleeping feet away from him in Gethsemane, but for those who would come decades and even thousands of years later. Something else would hold Christ's people together, something that no human divisions could obliterate, something that would never let them go. Love held them together. Grace held them together. The love that Christ shared with the Father before the world was born. Love would hold the church together no matter what division would come throughout every act of its life, right up to the final curtain call and into the everlasting cast party. That love would wash over new Christians at the baptismal font and would feed us all week in and week out at Jesus' table. Love started it all. And love would see it all finished, holding us all together until the final chapter. That love would make sure that we were held together as one, and that love would never let us go. This past week, as we were getting ready to bury Claire, we learned that another of our members, Shirley Manley, had died. And their funerals wound up being the same day. They both were laid to rest this past Friday. Something I often hear when a person is dying, something I hear either from the person themselves or from the family, is, did they have enough faith? Did they show enough faith? And that winds up being, I think, the biggest concern. Did this person show enough faith to make the cut? Especially if they haven't darkened the door of a church for many years. And that's understandable. Humans need boxes to check. We need criteria. We need to prove somehow that somebody is up to snuff. We need to define who is in and who is out. And if somebody doesn't make the cut cleanly and obviously, we worry about it. Fortunately, though, Christ does not worry about checking boxes. Christ doesn't worry about whether or not we meet criteria. He loves us too much for that. Love has an annoying way of clouding judgment, as Ben Randall found when he went out to rescue Jake from that sinking ship. When you fall in love, you do everything out of a desire to be with the one that you love, wherever that may be, and whatever the cost might be. And so Christ waded through the troubled waters of death this week to seize hold of Claire and Shirley and all of us as their lives ended, and as Christ will with all of us on the day we take our final breath, and as he does with everyone, no matter what we do or don't do, no matter how often we darken the door of a church, or no matter how shaky or unshaky our faith might be. We don't grab hold of the life raft that is Christ's love. It grabs hold of us. Christ holds us together that we may be one, and Christ will never let us go. So, the next time you feel caught in a hurricane, take a glance just below the troubled water. Christ will be there, holding you up, and Christ will never let you go. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
To tell the story of all.
With the whole church, let us confess our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed, saying, "We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Trusting in God's promise of new life, we pray for the renewal of the church, the world, and of all creation. Bless diversity in worship and ministry across all nations and cultures. Unite us in Christ and keep us faithful in our calling to show your love to the world. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Pour out over all the earth the water of life as a gift. Wash the wounds of the creation and restore all living things to wholeness. Protect ocean habitats, river ecosystems, and waterlands. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Give a spirit of collaboration to leaders of the nations so that all people know safety, security, and dignity. Heal victims of torture and liberate those who are wrongfully imprisoned or detained. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Come quickly to the aid of your people. Give wisdom and the gift of calm to military, prison, hospital, and hospice chaplains who stand as signs of your abiding presence. Refresh all who thirst for love, hope, or healing, especially Sharon, George, Lindsay, Nancy, Margaret, Diane, Rudy, Cora Lou, Martha, Arlene, Bobby, Bob, Len Jr.'s family, Claire's family, Shirley's family, and Betty's family. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Let your word fill our hearts and our homes. Bless all who teach us the faith, pastors and deacons, Sunday school and confirmation teachers, public theologians, mentors, curriculum writers, and publishers. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.